The last and loveliest with whom I shared my life left me 18 months ago, accompanied by what is technically known as the duly authorized officer. And those who had known for years that she was a paranoid schizophrenic but had not thought to mention it, did not concede it a chance to endure 6 months. I shall not write of her here. She is dowered as few can hope to be, and flawed beyond despair. When love seemed a relevant word, we lived a life of hermetic seclusion. When I woke to the truth of her condition, I had the fatuity to believe I could oppose myself to it and succeed. There are no witnesses. Even at those moments which we believed to be the most intimate, I came no closer than the rescue squad, who hear the faint rappings of the entombed and know that the fall must be sealed off. To be the paramour of one held to be a maniac is not precisely to live in society, more especially if she is related to illustrious men. At best, it fascinates morbidly those who can fancy themselves pitying the plumage, yet walk wide of the dying bird. But live on. There will not be a time when I shall not remember you. I am fed scraps of news about her. It is as though I am no longer to assume that that period of my life in reality occurred, or was mine. But it is very real to me, although, or perhaps because, I am no longer quite a real person. To have known something incapable of vulgarity is no small privilege. Body thicker, clumsier looking, especially so about the tail, reads the legend on the backs of fishing licenses, differentiating the young trout from the salmon par. So too the mind. The others will wash around in their little pools, rising to the same flies, sinking to the same caddis grubs as their sister fish. But when the peel and grilse are running, silver ingots in the dusk, I shall think of you, already far out on your mysterious journey, in steep Atlantic gulfs beyond the trawl.